Right to our WDSU First Warning weather. All smiles today with a Saints win. Beautiful outside. But there are a couple of clouds. It's a little bit humid. It's warm now, but huge changes set to come. And when you trap some of that humidity after a day of warmth, then we're going to cool off quick with under clear skies as we get rid of the last of those clouds. A little concerned about some of that smoke in the distance. And this dense fog advisory goes into effect tomorrow morning. That will trigger a WDSU First Warning weather impact day, where I think that fog could be the worst. So we get up to I-10, twin span between Lake Bourne, Lake Pontchartrain as you head up Slidell, and then we go to Hancock County, maybe even Pearl River County into Mississippi, and maybe to Gulfport and Biloxi. But everybody's shown in this gray shade all the way to Northern Terrebonne, Lafourche parishes. That's what I'm trying to get out. That could be the danger range where we could have visibilities reduced. So I give you really the impetus to use caution tomorrow morning and wake up a little bit early, especially anywhere within there. And tune on WDSU News in the morning. WDSU First Warning weather meteorologist Damon Singleton will take you through. I've got more here right now. But temperatures into the mid-80s, and we've got that humidity with a dew point near 70. When we cool down near there, that's what's going to form that cloud, put it on the ground as we start to relax the winds. Right now, anywhere 5 to 10, nearly 13 miles per hour. Bell Chase and even Lakefront, that's a wind averaged over a couple of minutes. So we see what's in our bigger picture for us. It's almost the ideal setup. When we get to this time of the year, we got a big cold front coming through. I'll show you how much colder that's going to be. It's warm right now, but we start to relax those winds, and here we see that colder air spilling in. Don't forget about what comes thereafter. That's for Halloween. It's really going to feel like Halloween, especially trick-or-treating. Might want to think about some coats and jackets for some. Right into the visibility forecast tomorrow, and here it goes. It shows the visibility down in this forecast gets as low as about a half a mile. There, you know, it could at least be as worse as that, maybe even close to zero visibility in those corridors, and even Bell Chase, even as you get towards around Louis Armstrong International, home on even Galliano coming in. You can see those projected low temperatures were right in line with those dew points I showed. That's why we're expecting that fog potential. So give yourself extra time, especially when you got to get to work, get kids to school. That's the biggest and most important part of this forecast. During the day, a few sun rays will come through the clouds. The north winds will start to pick up really strong. Temperature forecast is actually really hard tomorrow. I'm going to give us about mid to upper 70s, a little cooler north, a little warmer south. The front officially actually comes through earlier in the day, so that's why it's going to be a give or take. And also got to watch a small craft advisory, which could turn to a gale warning going into Monday to Tuesday. Not going to be good to be getting on the waters Monday night. I think Monday day up until the morning, midday, be okay. Lows Tuesday, 40s and 50s, but the winds are up enough. We shouldn't have to deal with fog. Clouds will start to clear. That means by trick-or-treating time, temperatures falling back with highs only around 60. We're into the 50s, my friend, and when you factor in a wind chill, it's going to make it feel even colder than this. The one thing is, I just don't have hardly any rain coming in. Maybe drizzle some mist, but look at Wednesday morning. Lows could be getting close to freezing, which I've got in the North Shore, and getting into the 30s, even some parts of the South Shore. Factor in the winds, we could be talking temps feeling like 20s to near freezing and 40 along some of the water. So look out Wednesday morning. It is going to be cold. Could even have some freeze warnings for the time of the year. It stays cold through Wednesday, stays chilly through Thursday, but by the end of the week, things will finally start to warm up. And then before our next front comes through by next weekend, but still just cannot find much rain here. WDSU First Warning weather. Got to keep an eye out for the fog tomorrow. Use caution. Then Halloween, be prepared for the big chill and look at the Wednesday, Thursday morning temps. North Shore, I got us freezing, possibly some to the upper 20s by Thursday.